So very good morning once again to all the students. After getting scolding from me, now I hope you will be regular enough in attending all the lectures. The way you were very busy, very serious in the beginning, now some of the students have become quite casual in attending online classes. So individually I will be calling and informing. Okay, so please be serious. We were doing the chapter, the Browning version. We have started yesterday. We did introduction in detail. But today I'll be giving just brief introduction because 2 to 3 students were not there. Okay. The Browning version, I told you the name of the chapter is actually, this chapter is adaptation from one of the Greek literature book, Agamemnon. Fine. And Aeschylus was one of the characters. That tragedy, that book was written actually about the relationship of a husband and wife, in which a wife cheats on the husband. So that Greek tragedy actually adapted by one of the, you can say, British writers, Robert Browning. So Robert Browning liked that idea and he adapted that idea and he wrote his version of Agamemnon, that tragedy, okay? So he wrote in English, though it was Greek, fine? So that's why the version, copied version or adaptation version was known to be the Browning version, clear? But this chapter is not written by Robert Browning, clear? So the name of the writer is Terence Rattigan. Terence Rattigan is the writer of this chapter. So he has taken the extract from the Browning version, clear? Ye kal bahut detail mein, those who are absent, they can listen to the lecture on the YouTube also, if you missed anything, clear? So that's why the name of the chapter is the Browning version. Otherwise, when you read the title, you will not be able to make out why this title is kept. Fine. So in this chapter, we're going to read about teacher-taught relation. Taught is student, pupils. Fine. Teacher-taught relation. Envy among colleagues. Envy means feeling of jealousy. So we will be reading about a young teacher and a middle-aged teacher, young teacher getting jealous of that middle-aged teacher, that how he manages the students in the class. Then another theme is limitations of education system. What sort of limitations, in which most of the teachers, they announce the results before the official date just to be in the good books of the students. But there are some teachers like Mr. Crocker Harris who do not announce the result before the allotted date. So they are very particular about it. Clear? Then last but not the least, we have need to inculcate discipline among students. That is also one of the themes of this chapter, in which the characters, now let's have a look on the characters. Mr. Crocker Harris, I have written the characters in the order of preference. Fine, first is protagonist, main character, Mr. Crocker Harris. He is the very strict teacher who likes to discipline students by giving them punishments, not corporal punishments. He does not beat them, he does not slap them, but he gives them some extra work, by making them realize, by calling them on off days to do extra work so that they realize that they have done a mistake in the past by not attending classes. Fine. This is the same thing I was discussing before when you were joining, that you are not supposed to be on relaxed mode during the online classes. So we have to be strict enough to make you disciplined. Okay. So Crocker Harris is, he teaches Greek literature in the class. So he's actually the teacher of classics. Okay, he teaches classics in the class. Then Frank is young science teacher. He's quite opposite to the character of Mr. Crocker Harris. He's not at all into creating the habit of discipline. He provokes the students. He keeps on, you know, getting information from the students. So Frank is young science teacher who is quite friendly with the students and who likes that most of the students should opt science so that number of students will be increased in his stream. And he is jealous of Mr. Crocker Harris because Crocker Harris is, you know, being very strict teacher, being very example of disciplinarian. Even then students like him, fine? Because students, at the end of the day, students are able to understand that more strictness does not mean the teacher is against us. More strictness here means the teacher is teaching us a lesson that we should learn something in life, okay? So then next character is Taplow. Taplow is a teenage student. He's student of Mr. Crocker Harris. Fine. So he's still waiting for his result. He has missed one of the classes of Crocker Harris in the past. So Mr. Crocker Harris has called Taplow to do some extra work on a off, on an off day. Fine. So Taplow does not like that rude behavior. You can say that strict behavior of Crocker Harris, but he does not hate the teacher. He knows that Crocker Harris is a man of discipline, a man of values. Fine. And after getting removed, after getting that certificate and result, he will be going to the next level where he will be able to choose between streams like sciences or arts or languages in that way. Now, Frank, you know, in the beginning of the play, what is the scene? Taplow is waiting for Mr. Crocker Harris, as Mr. Crocker Harris has called Taplow to the school to do some extra work as punishment. And when Taplow reaches there, Crocker Harris is has gone somewhere else, fine, and he was waiting for Crocker Harris. And by the time Frank meets him, Frank happens to come over there, and he asks Taplow that, what are you doing here? He says, I'm waiting for my teacher Crocker Harris. And he tries to get information from Taplow about Crocker Harris. He even says that your teacher is 10 minutes late, why you are waiting for him? But Taplow does not move from that place. He was scared of the teacher. He knows that Crocker Harris will mind if I go. So Frank was so jealous that how this Mr. Crocker Harris manages to influence his students even in his absence. So that is one of the themes. Okay. Then last character is Millie Crocker Harris, who is wife of Mr. Crocker Harris. Fine. But she does not have the, that you can say, a big role into the play. She will be appearing in the last of the play only. That what is her role, that we will be reading. Okay, I hope it's clear to you all. Yes, send me feedback quickly. Quick feedback, jaldi se, those who are listening to me, I'm checking. No feedback means nobody is there. Okay, Vansh, are you there? Fine, okay. All are there, fine, good. So I will ask any of you to speak in between also. See, we were on page number 51. So the conversation is going on between Frank and Taplow. Fine. And Frank asks him, Frank, the science teacher, he asked Taplow that your teacher, Mr. Crocker Harris, did not tell you the result before official announcement, that you have to wait for tomorrow. Means he's actually provoking the child that your teacher has not told you, but I have told my students. So he says, Taplow says that, well, you know what he's like, sir. Fine. This page we have read. So after getting to know that Mr. Crocker Harris does not announce result, then he changes his question. So Frank is going to ask about that which stream he is going to opt. Let's continue from that. Clear? Supposing the answer is favorable, what then? Oh, science, sir, of course. So he's saying he's not expecting that he will pass, or he's scared that whether he will get his remove that certificate or not. Who is afraid? Taplow is afraid. Fine. So Frank says, suppose you pass the exam, you get your good result, to get through it, then what will be the option you will be choosing? He says, science, of course, sir. Frank, yes, we get all the slackers. Now, what do you mean by slackers? Slackers here means the ones who are slow in studies. Fine. The ones who are, you can say, shirkers, who do not study at all in that way. So Frank is actually insulting Taplow here. He says, okay, yes, all the slackers choose our stream only. So Taplow protestingly says, I'm extremely interested in science, sir. So he says, sir, that's not like that. I'm not a slacker. I'm interested in science. Frank, are you? I'm not. Not at least in the science I have to teach. So Frank says, okay, you are interested in science, but I'm not interested in science. See, being science teacher, Frank is saying so. Taplow says, well, anyway, sir, it's a good deal more exciting than this muck, indicating his book. Now, muck, jisko keh dete hai, rubbish, nonsense, fine. So he says, sir, science is way better than this subject. So he shows one book which he was holding in his hand. Fine. I was telling you about the यू कैन से दैट बुक अगामेमनन ओनली. क्लियर? वो कहता है कि सर हमें जो हमारे क्रॉकर हैरिस हैं, ही हैज बीन टीचिंग दीज डेज वन ग्रीक ट्रेजेडी टू अस. कहता क्या नॉनसेंस है सर, दिस इज जस्ट नॉनसेंस. यू नो द वे स्टूडेंट टॉक, स्टूडेंट्स स्टार्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट, यू ऑलवेज हैव वन पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट विच इज योर फेवरेट एंड द सब्जेक्ट विच यू डू नॉट लाइक एट ऑल. सो Taplow does like science, but he does not like, you can say, the way Mr. Crocker Harris teaches. You know, Crocker Harris is a very serious teacher who does not crack jokes, who does not laugh in the class, who does not become friendly with the students. So that's why he says, see, sir, what I'm reading, this is just nonsense book we are reading these days. And Frank, see, a teacher should never use this word for the subjects of others also. That shows the status of a teacher. So being science teacher, Frank is also saying, what is this nonsense? What is this muck? Aeschylus, sir, the Agamemnon. So these are the names of, I was telling you, the real version of that book, fine? And your considered view is that Agamemnon is muck. So Frank says, it means this tragedy, this book, Agamemnon, is just nonsense. Well, no, sir, I don't think the play is muck exactly. I suppose in a way, it's rather a good plot. Really, a wife murdering her husband and all that, I only meant the way it's taught to us. Just a lot of Greek words strung together and 50 lines if you get them wrong. So here, Taplow is telling Frank that, see, sir, that, you know, the way we are being taught this tragedy, fine? Wife murdering plot, a plot of the story line of this book is very good. That there's a very suspense and thriller and action is there. But the way the Greek words are taught to us, 50 lines, and if you forget any one of them, you will not be able to understand anything. So the way we are being taught, that is tough to understand. So Frank says, you sound a little bitter, Taplow, means you are harsh. I am rather, sir. Yes, I am harsh, sir. Captain, he says, captain here means ki stay here, keep on talking to me, let's continue talk. Taplow said, no, sir, extra work on the last day of school. So this is the last day of school, the very next day result is there and they will get the remove for the next class. Now again, changing the conversation, Taplow says, yes, sir, I might be playing golf. You would think he would have enough to do anyway himself, considering he's leaving tomorrow for good. But oh no, I missed a day last week when I was ill. So here I am, and look at the weather, sir. So, you know, this conversation between science teacher and that young teenage student Taplow shows that teacher was not liking Crocker Harris. Taplow never showed his hatred for teacher, but Taplow did show his hatred for Greek words and Greek literature. Fine, and the way it was taught to them. So Taplow now says that, sir, you know that why I got extra work? Because, you know, this is the time, it was a holiday for all of us, you know, and I might be playing golf. Main golf khel raha tha jaake, sir has called me for extra work because I missed one day last week. And as the punishment, he has called me here. Fine, and see, look at the weather. What a pleasant weather outside, sir. This is the weather to play outside. And I'm stuck here to waiting for Mr. Crocker Harris. And Frank is adding fuel into the fire. He says, bad luck. Still, there is one comfort. You are pretty well certain to get your remove tomorrow for being a good boy in taking extra work. Now see the cleverness of this young teacher, Frank. He says, achha, it means your teacher has called you because you will do some extra work. And as a reward, he will pass you. By doing extra work, he will give you the remove. Taplow say, well, I'm not so sure, sir. That would be true of the ordinary masters. Very beautiful line. Ordinary masters. What does it suggest? Now you tell me. If Taplow is calling him ordinary masters, then who is extraordinary according to Taplow? Yes, Manjot. Who is extraordinary according to Taplow?
Crocker Harris.
Yes, Mr. Crocker Harris is extraordinary for this boy because he thinks other rest of the masters are very ordinary. They keep on telling results, they keep on asking for favors. So this is the another thing, limitations of education system. Fine, ordinary teachers, ordinary masters, those there are some people who even do not follow the norms. So this is for them. They just would not dare not to give a chap. Chap means beta, a boy. He's saying that they never will do this, a chap, a remove after taking extra work. But Mr. Crocker Harris will never do this. He will never give a boy like me a remove just because I attended extra class. No. But those sort of rules don't apply to Croc. Croc means Mr. Crocker Harris now. You remember, you might have, you know, sometimes we people have habit of keeping short names of our friends, our teachers, our seniors, fine, in that way. So he calls Mr. Crocker Harris as Croc. In front of the teachers, we become so good, so disciplined. You know, in our absence, how do you speak about us? In our absence, how do you, you know, take us? That is the true picture. So that is the true behavior of a person. So then he's saying the Croc. I asked him yesterday outright if he would if he had given me a remove. And do you know what he said, sir? So he's telling Frank, kehta aapko pata hai? I asked Croc. Uske muh se nikalne laga tha Croc, actually. So then he changed his word, Mr. Crocker Harris. It means usually he addresses the teacher like Croc. So he says, do you know what he said when I asked him that, sir, have you given me remove, or he would give me remove? He said, no, what? So he says, Chaplow, imitating a very gentle, rather throaty voice. Now see, here this is one of the humorous part of this play. Chaplow is going to imitate, copy the teacher, Mr. Crocker Harris. Kehta aapko pata kaise bolte hain? Means, in front of the young teacher, he is imitating his middle-aged teacher. Kehte wo apni heavy awaaz mein aise mere ko bolte hain. My dear Chaplow, I have given you exactly what you deserve. No less and certainly no more. Do you know, sir? I think he may have marked me down rather than up for taking extra work. I mean, the man is hardly human. He breaks off quickly. Sorry, sir, have I gone too far? You know, when a person becomes so casual with you, so friendly with you, so sometimes you get carried away. Aapko pata nahi chalta, aap kuch zyada bhi bol jate ho. Even you should see to whom you are talking. So Chaplow thought that Mr. Frank is very frank. See, name is Frank and he is also very frank in his behavior. So he says that, you know, that teacher speaks like this. Please underline this line, beta. Ye lines underline kar lo. That I have given you exactly what you deserve, no less and certainly no more. So these are the words of Mr. Crocker Harris. What does this suggest about character of Mr. Crocker Harris? Yes. What does these, you can say, what do these lines suggest about Mr. Crocker Harris? I have given you exactly. Yes, Mithali, bataiye. I have given you exactly what you deserve, no less and certainly no more. Crocker Harris ke words hai ye. What do these lines indicate about the character of Crocker Harris? Mithali Thakur, you're not there. Yes, Drishti, you can also participate, beta. Those who are not speaking, I will be marking them absent. Because if you're not speaking, even if you don't know the answer, if even then you need to unmute yourself and speak. Okay, ma'am, I don't know the answer. So that I can make sure that you are listening. So Drishti has not answered. Mithali has not answered. It means they are not there. Because you're not switching on the videos either. Fine. So I will mark you absent today. Diljit.
Yes, ma'am.
What do these lines indicate about Mr. Crocker Harris?
That he was a disciplined teacher.
Yes.
He was very strict with his rules and
And he never give marks by judging or by getting the extra work or by being, you know, favoritism. He has never shown. Okay, good. Diljit, you try to give answer at least. So this shows that Mr. Crocker Harris is proper disciplinarian. He follows rules and regulations. He does not, you know, give marks for the sake of giving. He gives marks as per one deserves. Fine. So I think he may have marked me down rather than abu kata mujhe to sir kam marks denge for attending extra class. He's that, like that only. So he is hardly human. It means he does not have human feelings, according to Taplow, that he does not laugh, you know, and the way he's too strict, he's hardly a human being. He breaks off quickly. Then he really, you can say, realized immediately that I have gone too far. Yes, much too far. Frank says, yes. Sorry, sir, I got carried away. Evidently, he picks up a newspaper and opens it. Air Taplow, yes, sir. What was the Crocker Harry said to you? Just to repeat it, would you? See, so Frank is enjoying when Taplow was imitating the teacher. Frank should not encourage that imitation. Because agar one teacher aapko kar raha hai, provoke that, okay, you should imitate the other teacher. So that is a wrong practice. So Frank is saying, dubara karke dikhana, that you were saying about Crocker Harris. Again, Taplow being innocent boy, he started imitating again. My dear Taplow, I have given you exactly what you deserve. No less and certainly no more. So Frank looking severe, not in the least like him. Read your nice Aeschylus and be quiet. Fine. Taplow with dislike Aeschylus. This is the Greek tragedy I discussed with you. Jo book uske paas pakdi hui thi and Crocker Harris teaches them Greek literature. Look, what time did Mr. Crocker Harris tell you to be here? Now see, Frank tried all the methods to make Taplow against, to turn Taplow against his teacher Crocker Harris. Kuch work nahi hua. Kabhi uski imitation karwai, then he added, he is not telling you the result about you and he's giving you some extra work on such a fine day in that way. And now Frank is adding more fuel into the fire. He's saying, see, what's the time Mr. Crocker Harris tell you to be here? 6:30, sir. Well, he's 10 minutes late. Why don't you cut? Why don't you cut means why don't you go from here? You could still play golf before lockup. So he says that you can go. It's such a fine weather day. You can go and continue with your golf. Really shocked. Now Taplow is shocked. Oh no, I could not cut. Cut the croc? Mr. Crocker Harris means cutting. Crocker Harris means not obeying the orders by Mr. Crocker Harris. So he says, I shouldn't think it's ever been done in the whole time he has been here. God knows what would happen if I did. He would probably follow me home or something. He says that I will never do that, sir. To cutting Mr. Crocker Harris, you can say instructions, that's not my cup of tea. I cannot do that. I have never done that earlier also. He can follow me at home. He's too strict. He's too particular. Frank says, I must admit, I envy him the effect he seems to have on you boys in the form. You all seem scared to death of him. Scared to death means ab itna zyada darte ho, so you're so scared of him. And I jealous him for this, you know, that how he can make students follow discipline. How can he make students feel, you can say, scared? What does he do? Kehta, beat you all. Maarta hai aap sabko. Kyun darte ho usse? Why are you scared of this teacher? Maybe he's beating you. Good Lord, no, he's not a sadist like one or two of others. See, baato baato mein, that child is telling everything. He's saying, no, my God, he never beats us. He never slaps us, never uses stick. He's not a sadist. Who is the sadist, beta? Sadist is the person who feels pleasure by inflicting pain upon others. Dusron ko dukh deke jo khush hote hain. They are sadist. Fine. So he says, my God, he's not a sadist. Like one or two or koi teachers hain, ek do aise, but he's not. I beg your pardon. He says, I feel sorry. Frank says, a sadist, sir, is someone who gets pleasure out of giving pain. Indeed. But I think you went on to say that some other masters, Now Taplow is asking some other masters. Wo kaun hai? Well, of course, they are, sir. I won't mention names. I won't tell the names of those teachers. But you know them as well as I do. Aapko bhi pata hai, sir. You know about them. Of course, I know most masters think we boys don't understand a thing. But sir, you are different. You are young, well, comparatively, anyway, and you are science. Your science means being science teacher. You are young also, and you follow the rules of science, and you are not like others. You must know what sadism is. So he's saying that, sir, see, what do you mean by sadism? That the person who inflict pain upon others and feel happy. So I think you know very well, sir. Aap young ho, smart ho, intelligent ho, you can understand. Good Lord, what are our schools coming to? So Frank aise show kar raha hai jaise usko kuch pata hi nahi hai. Achha, humare school mein teachers maarte bhi hai. Oh my God, what is happening in our school? So he's behaving as if he doesn't know, but he knows everything. So Taplow, anyway, the crock is not a sadist. See, addressing his teacher, the crock is not good, but he does not hate his teacher as well. That's what I am saying. He would not be so frightening if he were, because at least it would show he had some feelings, but he has not. He's all shriveled up inside. Please underline this, beta. Shriveled up. Introvert personality. Jo andar hi andar. Kuch log hote hai na, they shriveled up like inside. They do not open up much. We also have that personality in our class. You can guess who that person is. In our class, there is one child who does not open up much, who does not speak much to others, fine? I won't be naming, you keep on guessing. Fine, so shriveled up, every person is different. Some are introvert, those who do not like to talk to others. There are some extrovert, those who are quite talking to social butterflies. They keep on talking to others. Then we have ambivert personalities, those who are balanced ones, fine? So he is introvert, he's all shriveled up inside like a nut. He's just like, you know, he lives into himself only, just like a nut. So Mr. Crocker Harris, see beta, in the whole chapter, Mr. Crocker Harris is not appeared, but we are getting to know him through Taplow. Fine? Through Taplow, we are getting to know his character. So he's saying that he's all shriveled up like a nut, and I don't know any other master who doesn't like being liked. He is the only teacher who does not like to be liked by others. Usko nahi acha lagta ki usko koi like kare. Fine, so bell has gone, beta. We'll continue tomorrow. Please join well in time. Have a nice day.